Right, we're straight to the start line. The NACRA 17 started late, so they've got the windsurfers away a little bit early, and off they go at the start of this RSX men's medal race. They are underway in Marseille. Lots of pumping going on, as you'd expect, in this windsurf medal race. The top guys all here doing battle. The top six can still win a medal, so plenty to go for. But look, keep an eye out for the French sails, because all the French sailors are in the top three. So France 77, Pierre Lecoq out in front. Overall, we're talking about the man you can see there with sail number France 3. Thomas Goyard is in second place overall, and Louis Girard, France 1, is currently sitting in the bronze medal position. So those are the three medal positions, but chasing them, Paweł Tarnowski of Poland and Furmanski of Poland, they are fourth and fifth overall. But we're looking at Tarnowski right now, leading this little bunch of sailors, with Cheng Chung Leung of Hong Kong in the mix there as well. And Kieran Martin of Great Britain. Louis Girard, center of screen. And the overall leaderboard going into this race is pretty much what the finishing is, pretty much how they finished in Yair about 6 weeks ago, with Pierre Lecoq taking gold. But right now, data coming in and the trackers reporting that it's a battle for first between Tarnowski and Chun Leung. But early days yet. We're into the early minutes of this RSX men's medal race. And so far, no sign on our screens of Pierre Lecoq. Working hard, so hard in these conditions, that sail.
The RSX is so physical, especially in the light breeze. They really have to generate their own winds.
Yeah, one of the few classes that's harder work in light winds.
Yeah, it's crazy. You have to be extremely fit and extremely strong. And after the start, they're going full on, but they have to maintain this for the whole race. And you will see that everybody has a little bit of a different technique and just so they can hold on to it.
Yeah, just to reinforce that, the breeze has been slowly filtering out across this course. We started the NACRAs within 9.5-10 knots of breeze, and that slowly softened as the race went on to about 7.5. We have got anything from about 5.5 knots, 6 knots, which is why they're working so hard. So again, you can start to get some idea where the fleet spread out on that mini map in the bottom right corner. Two boards out towards that left hand side. We have Pierre Lecoq just tucked up in the middle part of the course, coming across on port tack, but a little bit further back from everyone.
So it's the Brit currently leading from Chun Leung of Hong Kong. And then the man from the Balearics that represents Switzerland, Matteo Sanz, sitting in second place. Early days, though, as they make their way up leg one towards that windward mark. No change currently to the overall medals. It's still a 1-2-3 for France, with Pierre Lecocq holding on to gold.
Well, current situation, just to give you an update of where he is, you can see it's flashing in and out of silver and gold. Just a minute then is because he is back in 9th, 10th position. He's still on port tack. The board's all coming in from starboard with better breeze now. But again, these light breezes. So we're just trying to track down. So Pierre Lecocq is this board tucked in the middle here of the screen. So the furthest one.
Yeah, we can see just like in the Nacra race that the left top, like from the left ley line, there's a little bit more pressure. And we can see that the two boats most on the left are gaining compared to the bunch that was a little bit more to the right. So I'm pretty sure that's also because there's a little bit more pressure and they can go a little bit more fast.
Thomas Goyard, center of screen. In fact, we have all three French boards there. You can see the gold, the silver, and the bronze all in that shot. But Pierre Lecocq is going to have to do something and work his way up the fleet, because at the moment, the gold medal that he seemed to already have round his neck with an advantage of 11 points going into this race is slipping away from him. As his teammate rounds the mark in the lead. And off they go. Goyard and Giard heading downwind, leading, with the Brit trying to keep up with them, trying for victory in this medal race.
So we can really see that they're using a different pumping technique than what we saw earlier on the upwind. They're like scooping, like you scoop an ice cream out of the box. They're doing exactly the same with their sail to make sure that they get nice depth, and then they push it a little bit forward to drive the board more to the front.
Well, it's turning into a disastrous race for the man from Brittany, Pierre Lecocq, who's now fallen so far back he's actually last and has seen that gold medal turn into a bronze. Early days yet, though. Plenty can happen. This is going to be a tiring race for these guys, trying to get each puff of wind, trying to fill their sails with every whisper of wind that's possible. You can see from the mini-map, they're all pretty bunched together, pretty close together, not much in it at all, and the concentration needed to stay in the hunt is very great indeed.
Yeah, so if Louis Girard stays in first position, then Pierre Lecocq has to be at least sixth if he wants to continue, if he wants to hold on to that gold medal. So he really needs to fight himself forward in this fleet. But there's still quite a while to go, so let's see how it will go.
French windsurfing, really looking, very, very strong.
Still looking very light out there.
We were talking earlier on during the Nacra 17 race about the importance of strength in depth and for the teams and to aid training and to aid fine-tuning. Well, the French certainly have strength in depth in their French RSX team. And right now on home waters, three of them are in the hunt for the medals. It was a 1-2-3 in Yerres, just down the coast, a few weeks ago. And we saw from the celebrations and from the interviews afterwards how much that meant to the French sailors winning on home waters. Well, can you imagine how they'll feel winning on the waters of Marseille, where the Olympics will be held in 2024, and, of course, in the World Cup Series final.
And it looks like Pierre Lecoq is making some huge gains, pumping for his life on that downwind.
But it's that Briton there who's in control at the moment. He's worked so hard on this downwind leg and has managed to edge forwards and ahead of Thomas Goyard. So he rounded the top mark second. He's now rounding the mark first as he heads upwind again. Kieran Holmes-Martin of Great Britain. Then comes Thomas Goyard and Louis Girard. Now, Radoslav Fulmanski of Poland, still theoretically in the hunt for a medal, started the day in fifth place. So he could, in theory, grab the bronze. But we'd need a massive shuffle of the pack for that to happen.
Pierre Lecoq in fifth position, so he made some huge gains on that leg.
So one downwind leg has seen Pierre Lecoq, who won in Yerres, move from last to fifth. So what's he going to do on this upwind? Can he continue that momentum? Or will we see him drop back like he did on the first upwind leg? Using that upwind pumping technique, which sometimes can seem a lot more violent almost than the downwind scoop.
Yeah, and it's so hard for these men, you know, they're working so hard physically and it's taking so much of their energy, but it's so important that they, you know, they keep looking over their shoulder, where is that pressure coming from, because that gives them just that extra speed they need and makes their life a bit easier. But here we can see that Martin is really in control and tacking right on top of Thomas Goyard to control his position. So there's a nice little battle going on there. Everybody's really close together.
So it's Britain, Hong Kong, Switzerland, according to that graphic.
Yeah, it looks like the wind shifted a bit to the left.
Yeah, just waiting for visual
confirmation
of that.
And a little bit more pressure also.
Yeah, the rest of the fleet all staying on that port tack. This breeze moving round to the left by some way. So as they rounded that gate mark, the breeze was sat up in and around 200 degrees, and it's now clocking hard towards the left-hand side over to about 170, so a big wind angle. So they're going to probably have to tweak this course when they get to the top end of it, ready for that reset. But it's
and it's certainly affected Pierre Lecoq. He slid down from mid-fleet to ninth.
But as it also affected Louis Girard, he is back into gold medal position. So they had a huge shift on the left together with a lot more pressure, I think.
And it'll be interesting to see the battle between Girard and Lecoq if they do stay shoulder to shoulder on this leg. Louis Girard won the World Cup Series in Miami. He was second in Yerres to Pierre Lecoq. Real rivalry between these two. And Girard, the 25-year-old, will want to beat Lecoq here.
Well, it's one of those ones where when he's that far back in the fleet, trying to get that clear air, trying to get that clear bit of water is really difficult. And certainly when the wind shifts so predominantly to one side at a race course, it limits your options of what you can do. So it's all for Pierre Lecocq to really work to get back into this when you can see the rest of them are just extending out in front of him.
So the leaders around that mark, remember in the RSX they're allowed to touch the buoys, so no penalties there as you'd expect in a lot of the other classes of sailing. Thomas Goyard just squeezed through on the inside and is heading off downwind for the final leg. There's Louis Girard round. And Pierre Lecocq near the back.
I think Pierre
is around that top mark. The Israeli Yoav Omer bringing up the rear. But it's all eyes now to the front. And just to see where this man, who's just getting round there, France 77, Pierre Lecocq, where to see where he finishes and if that is good enough to hold on to the gold medal position.
If it stays like this, Pierre Lecocq will win with just 1 point. So he'll have to stay in that position if he wants to hold on to that gold medal.
Well, I guess he will have done the maths and he'll know what's going on and what he has to do. And it'll just be a case of keeping an eye on Louis Girard just ahead of him and making sure he doesn't get away any further.
And it also depends on how Thomas Goyard is doing in the front, because they are really close together, and if he can still catch up on one person or not.
So we've flown to the front of the fleet. Matteo Sanz in third place for Switzerland. Struggled in a couple of the World Cup Series events recently, but he's doing the business here. Currently sitting in third. His race almost seemed over. In fact, the race for Cheng Chung Jung and Matteo Lance looked over at one point, but that wind shift brought them back into it. They read it well, and they returned. And he's had a pretty inconsistent week, has the Swiss sailor. But he's pulling out the stops right now. The Brits out in front, and by some way now. But the medal positions are as we started the day. There's been no change. Pierre Lecocq still just holding on to gold. So Kieran Holmes-Martin of Great Britain heading towards the finish line. Just the last few metres to go and he will claim this race. But the medals belong to France as things stand. So Kieran Holmes-Martin wins the medal race here in Marseille. It's looking good for a second place finish for Hong Kong, third for Switzerland. There's the finish line. And they'll be feeling absolutely every metre now as they just kind of drift over the finish line, exhausted after a race of pumping. Thumbs up. Yes, I've won it. I've done it. And the young Brit proving he is well and truly in the hunt for big, big future success. First class, then Switzerland. Now the first cross line in, and in the silver bar right behind it. And now Will Lecocq comes. We started the day fourth and fifth, are now across the line, and there is our champion with the sail number France 77, Pierre Lecocq. He won gold in Yair, and the man from Brittany has won gold here in Marseille as well. He pumps the air, another victory to add to his victories. But this is the big one. He's won the final. And for the next 12 months, he will be the World Cup Series champion in the RSX men's class. celebrations on shore by the French fans who've come to watch the windsurfers do their business. They were expected. They were expecting medals, and their sailors did not disappoint. They were expecting a 1-2-3, and that's exactly what they got. Pierre Lecoq, not just a great athlete, he's got a brain as well. He's a qualified dentist and took time out to finish those qualifications a few years back. But he's certainly back with a vengeance, and when he gets a race between the teeth, there's no stopping him.
Can't believe it.
So there we go. 1-2-3. Gold, silver, bronze lined up with the French coach boat, and we'll try and grab a word with them as well very shortly. Is there a bit of a competition, Evie, amongst yourselves, amongst the different classes, as to, you know, which is the most physical, which is the hardest?
Not really, I think. We just all respect each other. I think we're all different. Some classes are more technical, other classes are more physical. But I think we just all enjoy what we do. And I think sailors and the guys from and girls from RS6, yeah, we just... you know, have the same passion, I think, for water sports, and it doesn't really matter whose class is more physical. But I do feel that the RS6 is probably one of the most physical classes, next to the laser, of course.
Three medal races here in Marseille today. We've had two of them now, the NACRA 17 and the RSX men's. And we have the RSX women still to come. So let's try and cross to the water now.
Yeah, it's okay.
I'm hoping Pierre Lecoq can hear us. Pierre, congratulations.
Yes. Thank you very much.
There was a nice cheer from the crowd here as they watched that race on the big screen. Great to win yet again in France.
Yeah, second time in France in 2 months. So, yeah, I'm very happy about this win. We had some very nice week with perfect conditions. Not exactly today. The wind was very shifty, but definitely it's a very nice place for sailing.
Now, just talk us through the race and explain the trouble that you had maybe in the earlier part of the race. What happened, especially on the upwind, first upwind?
Yeah, the first upwind, I had a very bad start, and I was trying to keep clear about the other guys, having some fresh wind, but the wind was shifting a lot, and I didn't manage to find the good tempo. I did a very nice comeback on the first downwind, but then at the second upwind, the wind was shifting again. And I didn't sail very well, but I managed to keep the yellow bib, so it's the most important.
Yes, you did. But it was hard work, light winds. Are you exhausted? How tiring was it?
Yeah, definitely. I'm kind of exhausted because we had some very nice week with 9 races, and to finish the week with a physical race like that, it's always exhausted. We are pushing very hard physically, and definitely it makes some difference at the end.
Finally, if you could just give us this answer in French for your French fans. The World Championships are coming up in Aarhus. Your prediction for Team France?
French podium will be very nice, for sure, but it's a world championship, so everybody will be pushing very hard. Everybody will be, training very, very hard during all the season to be prepared for the worlds. So I think we can expect to have the highest level of the season, so for sure, French podium could be exceptional. I think that never happened on the worlds. But definitely we are pushing for that.
Well, congratulations, Pierre, and bon chance for Aarhus.
Merci. Bye-bye.
So a very happy Frenchman there. Let's just confirm his overall position then and how the medals were distributed in the end. Top step of the podium then to Pierre Lecoq. Second place to Thomas Goyard. And Louis Giard took the bronze. But Goyard finishing fourth in the end. And Giard finished.